After losing face in Ladakh, China is desperate to look strong in Taiwan, and it's using Hollywood visuals to prove it. At a time when China is still reeling under pressure owing to India swiftly changing its rules of engagement along the line of actual control in eastern Ladakh, India has now secured 6 more major heights along the de facto border. The latest development came at a time when some of the PLA troops have been stretchered off to a medical camp along the border due to their inability to withstand the high altitude and harsh winter, which is just the beginning. Having been beaten black and blue continuously by the Indian Army since June, the People's Liberation Army, which is a personal militia of the Chinese Communist Party, has ramped up its propaganda operations since evidently these are the only ones which they can carry out successfully. As per latest reports, China is looking to distract the attention of the international community from Ladakh and the extremely hot line of actual control with India to the South China Sea and Taiwan, while also activating its military theater commands which face the Korean Peninsula and Japan. To showcase itself as a formidable military force, the PLA is now taking to outright plagiarism with no shame whatsoever. As per a South China Morning Post report, the PLA's publicity team, which seems to have a disproportionate obsession with Hollywood films, has released a propaganda film showing the PLA Air Force bombing an American military base in the Pacific. Several of the scenes in the new video produced by the PLA Air Force showing a simulated bombing exercise on an American military base in the Pacific region look like they were lifted directly from the 2008 Oscar-winning film The Hurt Locker and the 1996 action thriller The Rock. China has in the past also used Hollywood film clippings to satiate its propaganda needs, with the PLA earlier using footage taken from the film Top Gun for making similar heroic films for domestic non-commercial consumption in China. In the film released on Saturday, H-6K long-range bombers are shown flying from bases in western China to the Pacific, where they drop their payloads on a naval base that has a striking resemblance to the US facility on the island of Guam. Military sources told South China Morning Post that it was not new for the Chinese military to borrow scenes from Hollywood films for propaganda purposes in China, revealing also, almost all of the officers in the department grew up watching Hollywood films, so in their minds, American war films have the coolest images. The plagiarized propaganda film on the part of the Chinese was necessitated due to the utter lack of face which they are being made to suffer by India and eastern Ladakh, especially along the tense Pangong Tso Lake, where over the past 3 weeks, as mentioned earlier, the Indian Army has carried out preemptive and swift operations to secure dominating heights directly overlooking the PLA troops and their camps, thus pushing them into an extremely disadvantageous position. In an attempt to cover up for their repeated losses in eastern Ladakh, the PLA is now stepping up aggression in the South China Sea and against Taiwan. According to a report in Nikkei Asian Review, PLA has mobilized its Southern Theater Command, which oversees the South China Sea, the Northern Theater Command, which oversees the Korean Peninsula, and the Eastern Theater Command, which oversees Japan and Taiwan. The Western Theater Command, of course, is currently occupied in dealing with India. The report also revealed that the mobilization of 4 other military theater commands was a distraction from the real standoff in the Himalayas. Where an actual military confrontation is occurring, that is in the Himalayas, the PLA is blasting Punjabi music and shying away from real combat, while in regions where there is relative peace, the CCP-owned militia is flexing its non-existent muscles. This says volumes about how China is looking to open new fronts in order to signal to the international community, particularly the US and India, that it is capable of taking on both the giants simultaneously. How far this proposition is from the truth is demonstrated best by the PLA's non-combative and psychological maneuvers in eastern Ladakh.